All righty, we're rolling around here on this sighting lap, and now we're done with the sight lap. We are now ready to sort these little fellas out there, Megawatt.
Hey, did you see, you pointed out there that 155 lap time and 250As last time around. That's exactly what we were predicting a little earlier this morning, like our first or second moto, saying that we might get down into that territory. And sure enough, a 155.5. So right now, about as good as you're really going to see this racetrack all week. Going to move into a lot more classes this afternoon, so going to get a bit more beat up. But ideal conditions right now for this 51cc group, 7-8 limited. So these guys, here they go off the gate right now. Rodney headed for turn number one.
Man, what aggression out of little youngsters like this. KTMs are up front. Look at that, bouncing off that first turn berm like that.
Holy cow.
That was amazing right there. Try to get a number on that one. I believe that's Braxton Watson out of Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, the number 41 here in the 51cc 7-8-year-old class. As we look at his moto scores from earlier, I believe that the 41 machine coming into this moto.
Braxton never shut that thing off around that first turn. Bounced off of that berm and was gone.
DNF moto number one, a 31st place finish in moto two. So he's out for redemption, man. He fired off that gate. I don't know what's got him charged up or what had him charged up, but whatever it was, Braxton Watson really wanted to prove something, if nothing else, off the start here today.
No question. Looks like he's still up there. So I'm not sure if there's been one lead change yet or not. There might have been one possible lead change. Those guys look like they're both on Cobras, look like very similar gear and that type of thing. But I think Watson may still be out there. And you're telling me a DNF and 31, you say, are his moto scores?
Yeah, looking at the 18, Landon Gordon. Gordon actually got second in moto 2. He finished 20th in moto 1, so he is out making some things happen. We see Braden Johnson back there as well, aboard the number 11. I believe that is the second place position. Johnson finished 16th and 6th, carrying it into the third moto. So, again, this third moto is going to change things up quite a bit. And look at this battle that is about to ensue already between the 11 of Johnson.
Look at this. Three guys right now, Rodney, trying to make it happen. Go ahead and tell us. Johnson was under fire right now.
Yeah, Johnson's under fire. He was trying to put the pressure on the 18 of Landon Gordon, but now here comes the number 80 machine of Jaden Palmer. Palmer actually took a Moto 1 win. He finished 5th in Moto 2. I think that was due to maybe not a great start, and also obviously the track there last night was about as rough as it was going to get for these 50cc riders, and man, they manipulated it very well, and it looks like we could be seeing some excitement about to take place here. 1-5 for Jaden Palmer, and he may be trying to work his way to the front of the pack for a 1-5-1.
Look at this. Here he comes right now around the outside, up and over that tunnel jump, Rodney, trying to set himself up for the inside of this next corner, going down by the billboards, not able to make it happen. But look at the first six riders, Rodney, how close.
A little huckabuck, a little bouncing back and forth. That billboard's got these guys way out of control. The 18 machine of Landon Gordon still maintaining the number one position. But look at this battle for second and how tight it is.
It's amazing. That first lead pack was originally six bikes hanging in there together. What kind of lap times are we looking at?
Look at Fowler. Fowler was in fourth when they came by. He's battling for second right now, I believe, as they head down the short chutes under the Red Bull arch down there. So Fowler's pretty much picking up with the pace that he left off with last night. The way we're looking at this, it is 7-8 limited. Landon Gordon out front. Braden Johnson was second. Jaden Palmer was third. Fowler was fourth. Austin Schaefer in fifth. Manuel Dumas was in the number six spot. Jaden Schlusser was in seventh. Enzo Timmerman was eighth. Tyler Cole ninth. Braxton Watson rounded out your top 10.
I can't believe what I just saw. Weege's eyes are wide open. Oh, and there's the end result. Weege, man, thought we were going to reel it back in. I believe he was going for the triple right there, man, and just bounced it off of that landing. But unbelievable. Taking a look now right back at it. Is that the 46? Is that Fowler coming?
I believe it is.
Looks like we've got the leaders right here, though. That would be right now. Is that still Gordon? Because it looks like the 18 up front. I can barely read that. So here they come one more time. That is the 46 right there. So that is Fowler. So he's put himself in
air.
Great position.
Did
Are you kidding
see
me?
The air launching off of that back section right there of the 46. And now, what is that, the 72 we're seeing move up there?
These two guys very familiar with each other, and I've seen this many times out of that 46 machine launching that thing, has willingness to send it, man, on those little wheels, man. This guy will absolutely get it done. And right now,
he was sixth place when they finished up lap number one. Manuel Dumas there, and Demias, I believe that may be how you say it. But look at him now. He is already up to the number one spot. Ahead of him, just a couple of spots, was Luke Fowler. So we've seen some big changes since that first lap of racing here.
Yeah, these guys aren't disappointing. Just like, look at this. Fowler going around the wide side, going around the outside. And look at this, holding the gas on just a little longer, getting a great drive, able to put himself back to the inside, Rodney Tomlin, as they come through and complete lap number one or two.
Lap number two, the leader's now up and over the Tunnel of Love, down in front of the big famous Loretta Lynn's billboard now, and it is still Fowler out front, and man, they are bouncing through that now whoop section in front of that billboard especially. It's a double-double section nearly for these 50cc riders. Demias there in the number two spot. Jaden Palmer in third. Landon Gordon, who was leading at the end of lap one, is fourth now. Jaden Schlosser. Schlosser holds pretty steady there in a fifth-place position. Enzo Timmerman is sixth. Austin Schaefer followed by Braden Johnson, Tyler Mollett, and Mason Tucker to round out the top ten.
Look at that three-way battle, Rodney, we have. I'm going to believe that that's probably Enzo Timmerman and Austin Schaefer locked into it back there. It looks like three riders coming down the short chutes here right now. Top four making a little bit of ground on them, pulling away just a bit. Each one has a little bit of a margin, but Fowler right now has set sail. Last time through, it showed about a half a second lead. By the time he'd made it behind the billboard, definitely was up to about 2 seconds.
Well, rolling through the GoPro 10 Commandments, our leaders here in the 51 7-8 Limited, Fowler, Demias, also Jaden Palmer, Landon Gordon, and Jaden Schlosser just 1.4 seconds back. But like you said, Enzo Timmerman, Austin Schaefer, right there in the hunt and thick of it as well. As we roll into Storyland, this could be a pretty good ending for some, and others may not have as great an ending to their story. Let's see what happens here. We're still early in this race, though. We got to take in the big picture here. 7 minutes into this third and final moto for these 51 7-8-year-old riders.
Leaders coming back around, Rodney. Look at this right now. Fouls are just opening it up, pulling away right now, working his way up over top of that rocky mountain right now. Definitely got clean track ahead of him, able to get in that race line, get in that groove right now, and starting to take that number 46 machine and check out right now.
Look at the attack mode this kid's in, up over the bars, elbows up, head down and charging, and good reason, man. He's got company coming in from that third place ride. Is that Gordon now closing up the gap? Actually, that might be the third-place ride we're looking at, but Landon Gordon back there on board the number 18 looks as aggressive right now as the 80.
Yeah, absolutely. The number 18 looking real strong right now. Landon Gordon looking like he's trying to get up there and get in position and make something happen. Leader going by already. Fowler out on lap number three that time, turning a 231. This time the margin waiting on Demise to come by. Now it is Palmer officially in that second spot. So 6.7 seconds back now behind Fowler.
Wow. So a big change again from lap two to lap three. We saw the big change on lap one. The 80 actually moving up from sixth in the first place to battle with Fowler for the number one spot. Fowler moved up from fourth to battle for first, but he finally able to secure this one here after three laps, rolling into four, 8.5 minutes into this race.
Top four starting to separate yourselves just a little bit, Rodney. You can see that Palmer just about a little up about 3 seconds right now, 9 seconds back to Timmerman. So that pace has changed up just a bit. But Schaefer still trying to get up there and put himself in that top four position, holding on to that number five. But the problem for him, Braden Johnson only a half a second behind.
Well, Manuel Demias, the 72 machine, we saw pop off a 231.248, which was the fastest lap that we've seen in this 50cc class. The second fastest was Fowler with a 231.953, so about 7/10 of a second difference. But the bad news about that for Manny is the fact that he has dropped back a few positions now as we look at the standings for the 72 of Manuel Demias. He's now back in eighth place.
A front runner early in this one, no question now, and just slowly worked his way back. A few little issues there. As we take a look from 10 up through 20, looks like Jaden Schlosser in that 11th spot. Cade Johnson on that number 17 KTM in the 12th spot. Gabriel Mahoney in 13th. Caden Wharton rides in 14th. Kai Burge in that number 15 position. Miles Monty in 16th. The 17th is Mason Nettleson. Chase Carr in the 18th position. Evan Woody in 19th. And William Kennegauer in that 20th position. Right now, it looks like we're just about almost 10 minutes in now, Rodney. Right at 10 minutes. There we go, crossing the 10-minute mark. And got a battle on our hands right here.
Timmerman moving up to challenge the 18 of Landon Gordon for a third. Not only challenge, man, threaded that needle heading over the Rocky Mountain. And he takes over the number three spot. So Enzo is living up to his name of being a speedster out there.
Man, Rodney, that looked like such a seasoned move. You know what I mean? That's a veteran move right there. This guy's just using textbook technique out there right now. And as a matter of fact, when you take in account and setting somebody up, that's exactly how it's done.
Well, coming up behind him, we got Austin Schaefer, Braden Johnson, Tyler Mollett, and a few of the other guys doing some battle back there. So we've got battles all through the top 10 and top 20 here in this 50 class, and we've got another lap in the history books. 11 minutes also approaching, and Fowler, Palmer, Timmerman now in third, Gordon in fourth, Braden Johnson in fifth. DeMias is back up to a fifth place position, so it must have been a mistake to set him back. So he's head down and charging against, but still lap time that time around for Manny was 2:36. He's still faster than everybody's racing against right there. So Manny should be moving up even more.
Look at this battle coming in front of us, Rodney. These guys still back here fighting. Four riders we could throw a daggone blanket over. But when you talk about DeMise, he's passed the same guys a couple times, it seems like.
Yeah, he has. And he may be actually pull off another fast lap in this one if he can get a little bit of free racetrack ahead of him and make up some of the time that he's looking to make up. I imagine if you look to the third place position. Enzo Timmerman about 13 seconds behind Jaden Palmer. If Manny's able to move up into that third place position, then lay chase to Enzo and the boys up there in second and first. We might even see a faster lap than that, but getting up to that point is going to be rather difficult.
Yeah, just the way all these guys are riding. And right now, these guys, they're riding on the best track they're going to see all week. And right now, the lap times will be optimum. Right now, to make these passes happen, a better opportunity than they've seen all week long. So right now, looking like four laps in, waiting on Fowler to work his way back around, trying to find our leader right now. Looks like he's coming back around. There he is, getting ready to head up over. Look at this, got a battle on our hands. He's got his hands full right now. Fowler has all kind of company from, it looks like Jaden Palmer and Enzo Timmerman.
Wow.
So look at this, my goodness. A little bit of contact there between the 80 of Jaden Palmer and Fowler. These guys pushing the very ragged edge, Rodney. Look at this as they work their way through the beach.
Yes, they are pushing the ragged edge. Fowler still maintaining that number one position, but also close. The number 80 coming in for that one. Jaden Palmer, Enzo Timmerman, as we said, really sneaking up in on this one. Or was that Timmerman?
If it White. Was.
You made a lot of time if it was, but regardless, the battle for first is on right now, and you say the white flag is out.
White flag is out.
Look at this. It's going to be a nose-to-tail battle here for this final lap of racing here for the
51-78 limited, and I want to tell you what, Rodney, it can't get any closer. It's coming down to the very final lap, and I tell you what, I don't think the top three spots are decided yet.
No, I think it's still up in the air and up for grabs. As far as the overall, if it stays the way that it is right now, Fowler will go 3-1-1 for the win. Palmer will go 1-5-2 for second place overall. And Jaden Slusher will go 2-3-12 for third. Now, here's the thing. Fowler has a little bit of breathing room there. If he is to lose a position to Palmer, he still would have the national championship. So the best thing for him to do is maybe back off just a little bit and play the odds there and take the national title rather than the third and final moto win. But how are you going to tell an 8-year-old kid that's in one of the tightest battles of his life right now to slow down and let that guy go by?
Yeah, that's not in his strategy, I can assure you that. Looks like he does have a little bit of a gap right now. What's happened to the number 80 machine? I don't see him in the picture right now.
Well, 80 might have also been last ditch efforting it on this last lap, which would have maybe put him in a position that he pushed it just a little too far. We talked wow. about the ragged but edge they were riding there, and that's what happens. Even in a 50cc class, when you push the ragged edge like that, sometimes it tears away and you lose a little time.
You know, fouls are coming up on one of the back markers here, but I'm telling you, I don't see that number 80 machine anywhere in the picture frame in the same section. So, oh my goodness, fouls are both feet off the pegs now. Needs to be careful. Less than half a lap away, got a championship in his hands right here. Coming up, that number 46 machine, if he's able to put it together for another half a lap here, Rodney, make some good decisions. Keep himself in good position right here. Just throttle back a bit. But look at the lead right now. Look, as we see Fowler coming right in front of us. Is that the 80 machine now coming up and over?
I think that may be. And wow, you're right. It did. There's your leader coming into the Sandy
I still don't see Palmer or something. Is that him right there?
Yes. He is not as far back as we had thought, only about 6 or 8 seconds or so. But Palmer is in the sweeper turn and heading to the finish, the final turn before the finish. But Bowser's coming up. Palmer behind him, a little bit of a gap. But I'll tell you what, enough for Luke Bowser to take the national championship with a 3-1-1 here in the 7-to-8-year-old division. Jaden Palmer will finish up second in the moto. That will give him second and the championship bid with a 1-5-2. And someone we haven't really talked about this moto, who is all the way back in a ninth place position. He finished 7-4, and if he can hang on for ninth here, that will be enough for a third place overall for Mason Tucker. But moto gold will go like this to Luke Fowler. He'll get the national title. Jaden Palmer will get second here today, and he will get silver, and Enzo Timmerman will take home the bronze in this third and final moto of racing. So congratulations to those three riders in their efforts and accomplishments here in the final race for these little guys. And congratulations again to Luke Fowler for the national championship.
Yeah, congratulations to Luke. A lot of hard work put in him by all these kids. And I can tell you, Rodney, we've watched this all week long. We've watched this situation develop. These guys look more and more seasoned each moto that we're looking at. And when we come through and look at the moves these guys use, look at the strategy these guys use, just like we were watching a full-size national.
No doubt. Rocky Mountain ATVMC leaderboard there on the screen. And Jason Wygant working his way down to the podium to talk to these youngsters and congratulate them on jobs well done here at Loretta Lynn's. You're watching coverage live from Hurricane Mills, Tennessee, and Loretta Lynn's Dude Ranch of the Rocky Mountain ATVMC.com Amateur National Motocross Championship, presented by Amsoil, the first in synthetics. Coming up, we got more 50cc racing here. We'll have the 4-6 class, followed then by a couple of double gates there. We've got a 4-6 special limited and 4-6 shaft drive. That will be our third, or what we call the C moto here in Loretta Lynn's, or at Loretta Lynn's, I should say. Let's head on down to the podium. Sounds like Jason may be about ready to get our celebrations underway.
Thank you, Rodney. All right, we're going to be joined by our third place finisher. Well, I had him. Let me do some more wrangling. All right, he's taking some pictures. I got him. We're good. Let's hand out a bronze medal to the number 21, Enzo Timmerman. Come right down here to the center. Come right here, Enzo. How was your race, Enzo?
Good. Got a decent start, worked my way to the front, and got third.
Who do you want to thank?
My mechanic, George, my dad, my mom, my grandpa, DT1, Mika Metal, CTO, Dunlop, 60, CD, Fox, and everyone else. Thank you.
Thank you. Third place, Enzo Timmerman. Good job for the number 21. Looking for Jaden Palmer on the 80, who's our second place finisher. We got Jaden. I need the 80 as our silver medalist in this moto. I see him. Well, this guy was up there all week long. He knows what it's like to collect some moto medals now here at the ranch. Let's hear it for the number 80, Jaden Palmer. Well, good riding all week. You were really solid. You'll be up there in the overall, too. Who do you want to, well, first of all, tell me about this third moto. How did it go?
It went pretty good. My start was decent, but the track was rough, and just had to pull through it.
Who do you want to thank?
My mom and dad, my little brother, Callahan MX Facility, Fun Factory, Truly, Motorvest, Garnet, 100%, Mika Metals, DT1 Filters, Bell Ray, and Dunlop.
All right, let's hear it for him. It's Jaden Palmer, second place. Thank you, Jaden. And now we will crown our champion. Thanks, Jaden. We will give a gold medal out, and with that, it unlocks the key to the national championship in the 7-8 limited class. Bring it on up to the center. Come on in. Gold medal and a title for Luke Fowser. Luke Fowser, you have it. We're putting the other ones on. Yeah, I like that. Yeah, they got the previous moto medals. We got all three of them. Putting the puzzle together. Oh, they're pumped. All right, Luke, tell me about your moto. How'd you get it done? There were some crazy battles going on.
Well, I got a decent start, like 8th or 7th, and I worked my way up, and I tried to get everybody in the Ten Commandments and just try to get everybody in the corners and work my way through up the pack. And Jaden almost got me right at the white flag, but I was able to hold him off.
Good job. Hey, did you think you could win the title when this week started? Was that the goal? Were you like, yeah, I can do this. I can win this. Is that what you thought?
Yeah.
Who do you want to thank?
I would like to thank Minton Cycle and Rob Minton for doing all my motors, Cameron Minton, Drew Minton, Carson Minton, Jade McCurdy, and Pro Taper, SRS Suspension, 6D, and my mom and dad and grandma and grandpa, and Aunt Sarah. Cobra, Bill's Woodworking, Scott, Motovest, and Rip Vinyl.
There it is. Luke Fowser, our champion of 7-8 Limited. And we will have the presentation of the number one plate. There it is, the championship trophy and the number one plate for Luke Fowser. Might have a Bell Helmets Hole Shot Award. I'll throw it up to you guys in a moment. If I put that together, I'll grab it back. But for now, we'll send it back to the tower.